Hello everyone and welcome to Split Second. My name is Cicada and I'll be taking you through today's match. Before starting, we at Split Second want to thank everyone for your constant support and suggestions on all social media. You can continue to support us by sharing and liking this video, subscribing if you haven't yet, by becoming a patron, or simply by not skipping the ads on our videos. This week we are playing with all new commanders and cards from Zendikar Rising. Join us as I play a Zagras Pinger deck. Luiz pilots Omnath, Locus of Creation, brewed by Nathan Jones with inputs from myself and Brayden and Ian from CADH cast. David is playing his own brew for Ashaya, and finally, Baal with his brew for Anawan, the Ruined Thief. Luiz won the highest roll, so he's the one starting. He mulliganed once and kept a pretty balanced hand. Floodestrand and Hollow Fountain cover up to 2/3 of his colors. Lanoir Elves ramp him up, while Mystic Remora allow him to draw cards at our expense. Force of Negation is pretty solid interaction. Emil is a combo piece or, at times, a value engine. And Dreadnith Magistrate is a really solid hate card. The Viz hand also has pretty cool potential. He has a Forest and an Ancient Tomb to bump his mana. Elvish Mystic is a good mana dork. Eternal Witness works for recursion. He has Urgothian Elder to provide him with infinite mana once Ashaya is out, while Nylea, God of the Hunt, and Finale of Devastation are both infinite mana sinks that allow him to kill the table. Finale is also good for reactive or proactive plays. David has a potential turn 3 win at the ready. Baal mulliganed once and kept a Snow Swamp and Scalding Tarn for lands. He had a Luther Ilkor for early card selection, Brazen Borrower for interaction, Snapcaster Mage to help him abuse stuff like the Mnemonic Betrayal he kept, and the always solid Intuition. Another well-balanced hand. Finally, I had to mulligan down to 5, partially because starting last made some of my first hands nearly unplayable. I kept Verdant Catacombs and City of Brass, both of which cover my colors. I have a Sol Ring to bump me a couple of turns forward, Robber of the Rich allows me to try and make up for starting with less cards in hand while also discounting my commander's cost. Demonic Tutor allows me to be more flexible. I sent Rakdos Charm and Inferno Titan to the bottom of my library. Time for some Zendikar hype! Luiz's start is a wet dream for many players, with an untapped Hollow Fountain followed by a turn 1 Mystic Remora. Neither of us is keen on feeding it. He passes the turn. David's own turn is pretty okay, with a Forest into an Elvish Mystic for ramp. So far, so good. Baal's starting turn is more conservative, with a Scalding Tarn into passing. I get to my own turn, cracking Verdant Catacombs for Badlands. Because I'm already 2 behind, I cast Sol Ring and give Luiz a card. He thinks for a suspicious amount of time. We wonder if he's considering a mental misstep and isn't using it since I'm already behind. My Sol Ring does resolve nonetheless. Luiz decides to keep his fish around a bit longer, since it has basically already cantripped for him. He then plays the Floodestrand, cracking it for a tropical island. With access to green mana, Luiz decides to play an Arbor Elf, which does untap his trop. He only lacks red mana for Omnath, should Luiz be looking to cast his Elemental Boy. David's turn 2 is mostly set up, playing Ancient Tomb and casting the trusty Sakura Tribe Elder, also known as Steve.
Oh, so that's not Alan. Steve!
On his end step, Baal cracks the Tarn for a tapped Watery Grave. On his turn, Baal plays a Snow Swamp and then casts the Luther Ilkor. This will give him a little more reach in terms of card draw. I start my turn with a City of Brass and casting Jeska. Baal reads her a couple of times, not getting the thought process. I point at my commander, giving all of my creatures Death Touch. Jeska is fired at Luiz's Arbor Elf, cutting him off of a potential Omnath on the next turn. Elf down. This also messes with his Remora's upkeep costs. I pass, satisfied. Luiz is not as impressed with Remora this turn cycle, but decides to give it another shot as he pays for it rather than risk casting Llanowar Elves and provoking Jeska's fireweaving skills. He passes, missing a land drop. Not a great spot. On his end step, David cracks his Tribe Elder, getting himself a forest. On his next turn, David also misses a land drop. Regardless, he casts Urgothian Elder. Baal warns us about how the Elder does combo with Ashaya for infinite mana, and that David only requires an outlet. He passes the turn, but not before telling Baal that snitches get stitches. Bal starts his turn moving straight to combat. He attacks me, mostly because my deck does literally destroy all of his creatures if I get to that state in the game. He draws a card and discards a Mnemonic Betrayal. He follows that with a Preordain, counting on either finding a land or in the rest of us being able to stop the vid. Luis's Remora nets him a card. Bal draws one and sends the other to the bottom of his library, but otherwise misses that land he needs, passing instead. On my turn, we all half hope I draw a land so Zagras gets the discount from Jessica's warrior status. That's right, she has that type as well, and I become able to deal with the Elder. That is not the case, however. I tap both colored lands to cast Robber of the Rich. I have no interaction and I would lose mana if I used Sol Ring instead. I attack David with it, considering he probably has the higher density of non-creature spells that don't feed the Remora. Ironically, I find a Nissa who shakes the world. Great for fetching me some forests with that ultimate, I pass the turn to Luis. The Remora goes to Luis's graveyard in his upkeep. Dutiful Field. He plays the Prismatic Vista he found and cracks it for a forest, just because the list does not run basic mountains or plains. He follows that up with a way to stop David from winning, Dranith Magistrate. No commander for him, nor for anyone else. He then casts a Ponder, ordering the top around my Robber of the Rich and drawing one before moving to the end of his turn. I use that moment to kill David's Elvish Mystic, just because it could make the difference between him casting a solution for the Magistrate and casting a Shaya on the same turn. David gets to his turn and decides to use one of his infinite mana sinks to try and find a solution for the Magistrate, Genesis Wave. He casts it for 4, and Luis sinks for a long while before letting it resolve. At this point, we conclude his free counter magic is a force, either of negation or will. David hits a 4 out of 4 permanents that he can actually put into play, them being everyone's new favorite budget-friendly Alasar's Shepherd, Findhorn Elves, Verdant Catacombs, and a forest. Not too shabby a turn. Bal starts his own by attacking me with the Looter once again, desperate to find that land. He fails that goal while discarding a Dark Deal. He then casts the Mana Crypt he found from Preordain and follows that up with Intuition, making all of us wonder. Luis decides to let it resolve and the pile actually consists of 3 lands, Command Tower, Sunken Ruin and Reflecting Pool. This means Bal really wants to make it somewhere specific with these mana costs. Luis gives him the pool, which he plays and passes. I cast a Rakdos Signet, managing to keep my mana healthy despite no land drops of my own. We're all playing Zendikar, but our landfall triggers are awful low. Since the table is moving towards creature grind, I decide to go ahead and cast Demonic Tutor, searching for a Basilisk Collar. Jessica's been doing really well so far, why not push her up a bit more? I move to combat and attack Luis, since he knows the top 3. I exile a Cloudstone Curio, which is a pretty nice combo piece. It does make me wonder about the other card he chose to save. With that, my turn ends. Luis opens his turn with a Polluted Delta fresh from his Ponder, cracking it for a Volcanic Island. He mocks the entire table by casting his own commander, Omnath. However, Bal isn't interested in giving Luis a card, plus he is curious about his interaction. He casts Delay on Omnath. Luis does not blink when he allows his commander to move into exile with 3 time counters. Luis goes to end step and I kill David's Alasar's Shepherd because I don't like the concept of him hitting one of us, possibly me, for 15. On his turn, David counts his mana several times to try and see if he can win, but notices he is 1 mana short for that. So he ends up losing a landfall trigger, playing his forest for turn, then using Urgothian Elder to help cast Rampaging Ballast. He proceeds to cast Nylea, God of the Hunt, showing us his outlet for infinite mana. Before passing, he does crack his fetch, triggering Ballast for a 4-4 beast. Bal loses his first grip roll. He now realizes that since I have no access to my commander, I probably tutor 4 Basilisk Collar to police the creatures on the board. He attacks David instead with his unblockable rogue and pulls a Yuriko by replacing it with Xerath, thanks to his rogue jutsu. This gives Bal access to David's Verdant Catacombs, which he cracks for an underground sea. He passes to me. My deck keeps providing me with solid ramp, this time in the shape of Felwar Stone. I then cast Basilisk Collar, proving Bal's suspicions right, and equip it to Jessica before attacking Luis with my own rogue. I hit an Enlightened Tutor, which, due to the Dranith Magistrate, I cannot cast. That's one less tutor for Luis's food chain, however. I pass, hoping for card draw so that I can responsibly kill the Magistrate and use that tutor. Luis starts his turn with a Savine's Reclamation, targeting his Remora. back to fishing, I use Cheska to ping David's rampaging ballots and kill it. I chose this moment just in case David has something like Nature's Claim, so he doesn't feed the fish responding with it. The ballots die. With the stack still open under reclamation, Bal decides to use his Brazen Borrower's Petty Theft to bounce Jessica, so I am forced to lose my next turn casting and equipping her. The stack resolves and gets us back again. The fish. Luis casts Carpet of Flowers after this, daring Bal to give him cards in exchange for countering it. He moves to his second main phase and the carpet gives him 2 green mana, which he uses to finally cast Llanowar Elves, now that they're no longer a target for Jessica. He passes. David starts his turn up with an Emerald Medallion. He then casts Eternal Witness targeting his Alessar's Shepherd, which he casts. It resolves, so now David casts an uncounterable Finale of Devastation 4-2, and I'm suddenly realizing where this is going. Collector Oof hits the board. Well, so much for my board and Luis's dock sidelines. With that, the monogreen player passes. Bal rolls for the crypt and has a little inception moment as the dice get stuck on my library, so he has to roll again. He does win. He attacks me with Zaris since Luis's lands only fetch him islands and he doesn't want to give Luis more mana for his carpet. I get hit and Zaris ramps Bal with my own catacombs for a swamp. Notice how nearly half of his land base came from Zareth. He follows out with a Sig River Cutthroat and forgets to tap his lands. That's okay though, because he remembers to do this somewhere during my turn. Bal moves to his end step and Sig triggers, drawing him a card. On my turn, I find and play a swamp. 3 turns of drawing mana sources, but I ain't complaining. I pass to Luis, untapped and ready to block with my rogue if necessary. Luis keeps his Remora around. He is also 1 turn away from casting Omnath. He casts Preordain and plays a Misty Rainforest. Afterwards, he decides not to hold onto a surprise Avonmind Sensor, also casting that to use his carpet mana efficiently. Luis passes to David. David starts his turn by slamming a Kendrith's Transformation onto the battlefield, aimed straight at the Magistrate. He does not pay for the Remora trigger. Luis can't counter this spell due to the Allosaurus Shepherd, so he transforms the Magistrate into an elk, triggering a draw. Now, at this point, we're pretty sure we're going to lose, but Bal reminds Luis that the trigger opened the stack before the uncounterable Ashaya hits the board. Thanks to this reminder, Luis is able to cast a Nietzsche's Claim on Kendrith's Transformation. David gains 4 life and then draws a card, but is otherwise prevented from winning this turn. However, he decides he can now start using combat as an option. I poke David about Sig drawing ball cards, so he is mindful of how he attacks. David decides to throw Findorn Elves, Collector Oof, the Beast Token, and Eternal Witness at the Dimir player. Bal realizes the hate Sig provoked, so he tries to defuse that by flashing in a Snapcaster Mage. He blocks the Oof and the Findorn Elves. David uses Nylea to pump both blocked creatures, killing Bal's and dealing some damage. He passes. Bal's crypt also betrays him during his upkeep. He casts a Gilded Drake, pondering for a bit. Since David hit him so hard, he is weary of the last turn's attack and losing some board, despite forgetting that what convinced David to attack him was me when I mentioned Sig. With that in mind, he decides against taking Luis's Magistrate and knocking Omnath out of the picture forever, instead choosing to steal Nylea and give Zareth Trample in the process. This allows him to move to combat and attack David with a guaranteed hit. He recovers Kendrith's Transformation and places it on the Collector Oof, getting me back online to police the table and drawing one in the process. He plays a Morphic Pool and finishes the turn with a Mystic Remora, letting Luis draw one from his own. On my turn, I play Ancient Tomb, my deck feeding me some more mana for good measure. I cast Jessica and equip my Robber with the Collar so that I can attack with less fear of him getting removed. Luis loses a mana confluence to it. I then equip Jessica and pass, ready to kill whatever is required. Luis casts his Omnath as the last time counter wears off. Bal considers countering it, but chooses not to despite the fear of the Ikoria free spells, Fierce Guardianship, and Deflecting Swat. The draw trigger enters the stack, and Luis casts Worldly Tutor, triggering Bal's Remora. The tutor resolves and Luis gets a Squid Immortal, revealing a food chain plan. With the Omnath still on the stack, I activate Jessica, killing Omnath. Luis has Savine's Reclamation at the ready in his graveyard, which could give him some lands to trigger Omnath's ritual effect while ramping him. I am also less afraid of a Dockside Extortionist plan, now that Luis has Tutor for Squee. Luis lets the Remora die. He adds two green with the carpet and cracks his rainforest for an island. He plays a savanna to make sure he has mana for a counter war and casts Food Chain, drawing Baal a card. There's a risk that this is the winning turn, but Baal does cast Mana Drain on it to try and stop him. Luis has Dovin's Veto at the ready, which he casts, triggering Baal's Remora again. Baal does draw a miscast, but it's worthless here. Luis now exiles both Mind Sensor and Llanowar Elves, keeping mana up for Force of Negation should one of us have removal for Food Chain at the ready. We do not, so now he's able to cast Squeedy Immortal unimpeded and exile it to Food Chain to generate infinite mana of all of his colors. Luis then casts his commander and exiles it to Food Chain over and over until he draws his entire library. Now, you might be expecting a Thassa's Oracle, but he's not sporting any of that nonsense. Instead, he casts a Walking Ballista for an ultra-large number and pings us all to death. Good game! Thanks for joining us for today's match, everyone. Omnath was able to dominate this game. We'd like to start the credits by thanking our current patrons and especially Izanagi, Stefan, TJ Rapp, Mike Purr, Ajimo, and Igligal, our stack breakers. If you want to support us, you can do so by liking this video, subscribing, or by becoming a patron yourself. If you want to go through other Commander adventures, click one of the videos on the right. If you want to talk with us about our games or other EDH-related matters, join us on Discord. Come with us again next week for a new set of Commanders and more decisive plays. See you all then!